Thomas Kiander, Lieutenant. I graduated from Michigan State University single, and the draft was in place, and I was not in any relationship. I was single, and the Navy had a program from college to the quarterdeck through Navy OCS, and I signed up, and shortly thereafter I went to Navy OCS in Newport, Rhode Island, and 4 months later I was awarded a gold bar and orders to go to the fleet, and that began or continued my Navy career. It was huge. I'm a free spirit, I had no questions at all about that. In college I was in a fraternity, and I was your stereotypical guy that could study and knock out any exam, and that left time out for my friends and activities. Now all of a sudden I'm going to be in one place and taking orders, and when I laid down at my bunk in OCS and looked up above me, I said, "Lord, what am I doing here?" But that was a commitment that I had made. I had been in scouting. I was an Eagle Scout, so I knew some discipline. But it took a real, it was a real challenge. And yet it was great, great experience and very rewarding. Basically, I had a choice between the Navy and the Marine Corps. And I just felt that there were going to be some unusual physical requirements for the Marine Corps. And I was pretty technically capable in college, so I figured with those courses I'd be better at the training course for Navy OCS rather than the Marine Corps, so I elected to go into the Navy. This was before the Vietnam War. It was basically nothing other than I would say it's a police action, but there was very small troops there. It was nothing much to do with the training or planning or thoughts at all. I know later on things picked up heavily. In fact, right while I was in service, it picked up tremendously. We landed troops and supported them, and our commitment over there really, really expanded. But at the time, it was just Navy tactics, gunnery and engine work, navigation, seamanship, all the courses you'd expect to be able to serve aboard ship as an officer. Very green, but with the basics to get in and get qualified. Well, OCS, we were up at least by 5:30, I believe, and then by 6 we would be squaring ourselves away and cleaning the barracks and lining up, and then we'd march off to chow and then off to our classes. So we marched everywhere. And the main thing was that if we drew late night watches, it didn't matter. You still had to go through the program the next day. So if you had a mid watch or a night watch from 12 to 4, you had about an hour and a half's worth of sleep, and you'd get right up and get back at your program. And the training itself consisted of black and white movies that seemed to drone on, but you had to stay awake. You couldn't. You're gonna slip into a slumberland. You had to lean against the wall to keep your eyes open, or you'd get gigs, which are the Navy's version of markdowns. Demerits are the Army and other services. So you want to minimize those gigs. Well, you know, you learn discipline. You learned you're held responsible, and you were trained. And I always in a fraternity wore a sport coat and tie, so I was familiar with that. But you had to learn how to get yourself squared away, clean. Your uniform had to be in ship-shape condition, and so you had to, you know, things like shining your shoes and polish the brass and do all those things. That was training and discipline necessary. You're going to represent. You're going to step out on board the deck of a ship, and the men had to follow you or. You're not doing your job.